In this video, we'll be discussing regarding the transistor's modes of operation and also a very important aspect, how to apply transistors in electronic projects. So first of all, we will start with the modes of operation of the transistor. So as you can see over here, transistor supports three modes of operations. First one is the cutoff mode, second one is the active mode, and third one is the saturation mode. Now what is this cutoff mode? In the case of this cutoff mode, the transistor won't be conducting current from collector to emitter. Now what about the saturation mode? Saturation mode is a mode in which the transistor will be conducting current from collector to emitter. Basic and widely used modes are the cutoff mode and the saturation mode. That's why I have just given a brief idea about the cutoff mode and saturation mode over here. I am not at all explaining regarding the active mode. Still, if you need to find out more about the active mode, I'll be doing a video on the active mode separately. Why I am focusing on the cutoff mode and saturation mode is that in most of the electronic projects, we'll be using a transistor as a very basic circuit, that is as a switch only. So transistor as a switch, it will be working based on two modes alone, that is the cutoff mode as well as the saturation mode. What is this cutoff mode? Cutoff mode means the transistor is completely off. That means no current flow will be there from collector to emitter. So if we are considering this transistor as a switch, in a normal switch, it consists of two separate pins only, and this pin to this pin, it will be connected when the switch is on, and this pin to this pin, it will be disconnected when the switch is off. So why this transistor is having three pins? Here, the transistor, it will not be working as a physical switch. Instead, this is a switch which can be controlled using a third pin, that is the current and voltage variations in the third pin, that is pin B. B is nothing but the base. C is the collector and E is the emitter. So just like we are using a switch in such a circuit, we can directly use a transistor also. In the coming videos, we will be see how to use that. Now, more about this cutoff region and the saturation regions. Cutoff region means the transistor is completely off. Just understand this fact. Whatever voltage you are giving over here, that have to be given between the base and the emitter. So here, if you are giving some voltage, and if that voltage is less than 0.6 volt, then the transistor is off. That is, this conduction, collector to emitter conduction, will not be happening. And if you are giving a voltage between this base and emitter in such a way that that voltage is more than 0.6, then of course the transistor will be on and current will be passing from collector to emitter. This portion will be shorter. This is how a transistor will be working in transistor as a switch condition. So as the concept of the transistor as a switch is clear, we will just see how to apply this concept into reality. Or using transistor as a switch concept, how we can build real-time projects. So for that, first of all, we'll just see a very basic circuit using a transistor as a switch condition, in which we are just turning on and turning off an LED based on the configuration. So here you can see, this is the transistor as a switch condition, and here we are having an LED. Okay, so apart from the LED, we can see certain resistors here also, correct? So here one resistor is there, RB, and here one resistor is there, RC. What is this resistor RB? That is nothing to worry about. Here this resistor is connected to the base of the transistor. So as it is connected to the base of the transistor, it is simply called by the name base resistor or RB. And here, as you have already guessed, a resistor is connected to the collector of the transistor. So that's why this resistor is known by the name collector resistor. Is it only the LED that can be controlled in this manner? No way. LED is just a basic component that I have shown for simplicity. Apart from the LED, you can control any electronic components using this method. But the only condition is that you have to select an appropriate transistor for that scenario. Anyway, before starting to make this device work, we have to design these resistors. Is that right? Yes, we have to design these resistors first. So for that, first we'll start with designing the resistor at the collector point. That is, we are going to start with step number 1. Here you can see in the step number 1, this is how we'll be designing the resistor at the collector point. You might be a bit frightened by seeing some equations and all, but it is nothing to worry about. Always in all such scenarios, we'll be using the same circuit only and we'll be using the same equations only. And this is very easy to understand also. Okay, let me explain how to do this thing. So here this resistance, that is known by the name collector resistance or RC. It is given as VCC, RC, near to RC we are giving a supply, right? So this supply is known by the name VCC. VCC minus, what was the voltage requirement of this LED? That is VLED. Yeah, again the transistor is also there in this path, correct? So this transistor also requires some voltage, that is this VCE, because the transistor's voltage in this path, that will be passing through this point only, that is from C to E. So across that some dissipation will be there, that is VCE. And also we will be considering VCE at saturation condition only, because previously we have understood the transistor will be working in 3 main methods, out of which only 2 will be used for transistor as a switch condition. So the first mode is transistor in cutoff and second mode is transistor in saturation. We are going to consider a transistor in saturation over here. Why is that so? Because only in transistor in saturation this thing is going to work, or transistor will be on, or voltage or current flow will be present. So from where we will be finding out this current? Of course, the current whatever we need to consider, that is will be the current rating of the device only, whatever we are using it over here. So here we have used an LED. So of course you know, the previous cases also I have shown you, the current requirement of the LED is very less. That is nearly 15 milliamperes only. So you can just write over here 15 milliamperes, correct? So milliamperes, you have to convert that into amperes. So 15 into 10 raised to minus 3 will be coming. What about the other values? VCC, that anyway we are going to give 5 volt. What about the VLED? In the previous videos, in one table I have shown you different voltage ratings for different LEDs. If it was a red LED, then the VLED will be coming near 1.8 or 1.9 volt, the average value. So I have put 1.9 over here. Minus, of course, across this junction also some voltage drop will be there, that I am just putting it as 0.1. This value you are getting from the data sheet only. About data sheets, anyway, I will be doing a separate video. So finally, RC, it can be found out by solving these values. So finally, the value of RC is 200 ohms. Okay, so now we have got one value over here, that is RC. Now what about RB? RB also is somewhat related with RC only. So for finding out this RB, first we need to know what should be the current requirement over here. Okay, so for calculating the IB value, what is this IB again? IB is nothing but the current flow in the base junction. So for finding out the IB value, what we have to do? We have to consider IC first. IC was the current in the collector pin. So IC we already know over here. IC was 0.015. Okay, now we will just see the step number 2, that is calculation of IB value. What is this IB? Earlier whatever current I mentioned regarding the LED, that was termed as IC. Why it is termed as IC? Because this LED is near to collector. That's why I am calling it as collector current or IC. Okay, so based on this, I also need to understand that is some current will be over here. I need to find out that current also. IB will be calculated like IB is equal to IC by beta. What is this beta? Beta is some value that you will be getting from each and every transistor's data sheet. But for ease of remembrance, we will just imagine beta for any transistor that will be ranging from say 10 to 100 or something. So this beta value it can be taken as say 10 itself. We will consider it as 10 itself. So over here, what we have to do, this value divided by 10 we have to. So what will be the final value over here? That will be 0.0015. Now we will go to step number 3, that is finding out the RB. As of now, we have already calculated RC. Then I told this IB is required to calculate RB. Due to that, we already calculated IB also. Now we are at the third step, that is calculation of RB. How to calculate RB? We will be following the same method. We will not be taking the VCC from here. Instead, here we are going to give one voltage. That voltage is V in only. Okay, this voltage is something that is used for controlling the transistor. If this voltage is here, transistor will be on. This is not here, transistor will be off. RB can be calculated using this equation, that is V in minus. Here no LED or nothing like that is there. Due to that, we need not do this thing. Okay, anything else is there? Here VCE was there. It was minus. Correct. So just like that, in this path also some dissipation will be there. That is VBE. We have to minus this thing. And VBE, for most of the transistors, it is nearly 0.6 to 0.7 volts. So finally, RB can be calculated like this. RB is equal to, here the voltage will be 5 volts minus 0.6 or 0.7. That is the VBE value, all divided by, what is this, 0.0015. So finally, the value is this much. So now, as we have completed the design part, we'll just see whether the circuit is working or not. So now I am going to simulate the entire circuit working. Already I have drawn the circuit and I will just see whether the circuit will work or not. So for that I am just turning on this thing. Okay, whenever the switch was on, it was working fine. Okay, when the switch is off, LED is also off. So circuit is perfectly working fine. So the very next day, I will just come with another video on how to control this LED in the opposite manner. That is, whenever the switch is on, LED have to be off. And whenever the switch is off, LED have to be on. We will just try to make it more interesting in the coming weeks. Thank you.